Hello, welcome back to the second part of fractions, and in this video I'm going to focus on how to compare fractions. Okay, so I have here six different methods. Let's start with the first one, which is the most common one. Okay, let's change all the fractions to the same denominator so that we can compare which one is smaller and which one is bigger. So for example, if we are asked to compare 3/4, half and 5/8, what is the common denominator? 4, 2 and 8. So the common denominator, the lowest common multiple is 8. So 3/4 is equals to 6 out of 8. Basically what I need to do is to cut the model into 8 parts and shape 6 parts. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And half is equals to 4 out of 8. Okay, so if I cut the model into 8 parts and half will be 4 out of 8, and 5/8, I need to cut the model into 8 parts and shape 5 parts, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So if I'm asked to arrange from smallest to biggest, it will be 4 out of 8, second is 5 out of 8, and the biggest is 6 out of 8. Okay, so from here, you can see that the smaller the numerator, the smaller the fraction. Okay, the bigger the numerator, the bigger the fraction. So this is how you compare fractions using same denominator. How about the second method, using same numerator? So let's look at, for example, let's say I change the numerator to the same. Let's use unit fractions. Okay, so what is the difference between 1/4, half and 1/8? Okay, which one is the smallest? So 1/4, okay, actually what we need to do is to cut the model into 4 parts, okay, and shape 1 part. So this is 1/4. Half, we cut the model into 2 parts and we shape 1 part. So this will be half. And 1/8, we cut the model into 8 parts and we shape 1 part. So from here, you can see which fraction is the smallest. Yes, 1/8. Second will be 1/4. And the biggest one is 1/2. So here, you can see very clearly that the bigger the denominator, the smaller the fraction. Okay, the smaller the denominator, the bigger the fraction. So this is how you can use the same numerator method. Okay, so this will come in handy, especially if you are trying to compare fractions with big denominators. Okay, for example, 3 out of 14 and 1 out of 5. If you want to know which fraction is bigger, and then you choose number 1, method 1, same denominator, then you will have to do 14 times 5, which is a big number, right? It's easier if you just change 1 to 3. So times 3 times 3, 1/5 is equals to 3 out of 15. So 3 out of 14 and 3 out of 15, which one is bigger? For same numerator, the smaller the denominator, the bigger the fraction. So this symbol means more than. Okay, so can you see that the open mouth is facing the bigger fraction and the closed mouth is facing the smaller fraction. Okay, so this is how we can use the same numerator method. Now, what about the minus unit fractions? Okay, so sometimes, okay, for example, if you get 11 out of 12 and 13 out of 14, can you immediately tell which number, which fraction is smaller and which fraction is bigger? Okay, if you try to change to common denominator, what is the common denominator between 12 and 14? Again, it's going to be a big number. How about 11 and 13? Also a big number. But what do you notice? 11 out of 12 is actually 1 minus 1 out of 12. And 13 out of 14 is 1 minus 13 out of 1 minus 1 out of 14. So we can use minus unit fractions to help us. Okay, so what do I mean by that? So 1 out of 12 and 1 out of 14, let's compare these two unit fractions. Which one is big, which one is small? So 1 out of 12, smaller denominator, bigger fraction. Bigger denominator, smaller fraction. So if you take one whole and you take away a big part of it, that means what is left will be small. And if you have one whole and you take away a smaller part, that means what you have left will be big. Okay, so 13 out of 14 is bigger than 11 out of 12. So this method uses the minus unit fractions method. Okay, now let's look at the other methods compared to half. So sometimes if you are comparing two fractions, let's say for example 2/5 and 3/4, you don't even have to change to the same denominator or the same numerator because you can compare it to half. So 2 out of 5, what is half of 5? Half of 5 is 2.5. Okay, so we know 2 out of 5 is less than half. And what is half of 4? Half of 4 is 2, that means half is 2/4. And 3 is more than half. Okay, so sometimes it is easier for us to just compare the fractions to half. Okay, so if it's less than half, it is definitely smaller than fractions that are more than half. So that is method number 4. Okay, so method number 5 is changing it to decimals. So 2 out of 5 is 4 out of 10, so the decimal is 0.4. 3/4 is 0.75. So you can see this is 4 tenths and this is 7 tenths, so this is bigger. Okay, 0.75 is bigger than 0.4. But sometimes it's not easy to convert the fractions to decimals because you will get recurring decimals. Okay, so the final method is my favorite method, which is the crisscross method. How to use the crisscross method? Crisscross. 2 times 4 is 8. 5 times 3 is 15. So 15 is bigger than 8. So 3/4 is bigger than 2/5. Basically, there is a pattern. Okay, so these are the 6 methods you can use to compare fractions. Hope this has helped you to understand comparing fractions better. See you in the next videos where I'm going to focus more on the word problems. Bye.